All right. Again, happy Mother's Day to everyone. All right. Happy Mother's Day. So I assume lahat na nag-attend dito ay mothers, no? And yung mga hindi pa mother and soon to be mother, pwede pa rin mag-attend naman, di ba? So happy Mother's Day to Ax, Agravante, Michelle, Jewel, and dami, no? So Froline, Abangan. So I want to make this meeting a little bit interactive. So you can, kasi pag nag-class ako, no, normally live class, no, face-to-face to mga tao. But since we are doing this online, so yung means of communicating lang natin ay using the chat box of Zoom. So, get your chat box ready para ma-shoutout natin at saka mabasa natin yung mga responses nyo para exciting din naman, no? Hindi lang ako yung nagsasalita, at least my participation. Alright, so now before I start, I want you to share a little bit short lang your how does your child or your children address you? Is it mama, nanay, mommy, momshi? No, please chat and share. My son calls me Mama. Mama, Sherry Lim, Irish, Joy, Mama, Mommy, Axe, Precious, Mama, Len, Mommy, Mama, Momshi. Very good. Hi, Mama. All right. That's great. All right. So, okay. So, welcome to our class, mothers. No. So, ang title ng class natin ngayon, mga pera kaalaman para sa ilaw, para sa mga ilaw ng tahanan. All right. So, happy Mother's Day to everyone. So, let's proceed. No. Okay. By the way, the picture is me and my son. No, I just realized I should have chosen a different picture. Yung masaya. Parang hindi ako masaya dyan. But actually, masaya po ako. Sa picture lang, parang hindi masaya. No, so, alright. Okay. Alright, so, by the way, my name is Rose. Rosie. My close friends call me Rosie. But ang name ko lang talaga is Rose. I'm 30 years old, no? So, binigay ko na yung age ko, di ba? So, and then, I'm a graphic designer and a former employee, now an entrepreneur and a full-time financial coach of IMG since 2014. And I'm also an investor. Now, that's my contact details. So before we proceed, I want you to share a little bit of your motherhood story there. So let's say, ilan yung anak mo? Are you a working mom or are you a stay-at-home mom? Share on the chat box so that we can shout out, or you are what's the name of your son? So anything, or your children, or your daughter? So anything na interactive. So from Axel, nice kayo ang title sa webinar. Wow, so the title was written by Ma'am Joanne. No? So working mom with two sons, Sherry Lim. No? So a working mama of two daughters, Lenlen de Mesa, two OFW po, Kim and Seth, stay at home mommy to my 10-year-old daughter, Sam. Very good. Thank you so much. And now it's my turn. From Axel Agravante, work at home mom with one daughter, 4 years old. So, all right. So I'm going to share. It's my turn to share my story. No, so, yon. I started a family at age 21. So, di ba? Shocking. So, I'm already 30 years old now. And then, my son is already 8 years old. So, bale, to make a confession, I started my motherhood journey unprepared in all aspects of my life. Unprepared emotionally and unprepared financially. No, but I, as a better person, it made me stronger and it made me strive hard in life. And now, I'm working and stay at home at the same time kasi I'm a financial coach of IMG. I'm working at home and also I can spend time with my son anytime. No, and then I'm living my dream because I can provide okay for my family, and then my husband doesn't need to go away and work abroad just to provide for us. So I'm just gonna close the chat box kasi maingay po yung browser ko. 1 second ha. Right. Okay. Can you see my screen? Yes? Hello? All right. Thank you. Okay. So, yeah, I'm living my dream. And, yeah, this is the dream that I wanted before. Kasi when I started a family, I need to work in Cebu, and then I left my son to my mom in Bohol, and I'm away from him, and that's really not the life I wanted. So no offense to people who are working away from their children, but it's better to be with them, no? So that's why I'm so thankful that I'm a part of this organization called IMG. It allowed me to earn at the same time stay at home with my family. So yep, all right, so let's proceed. Okay, for this evening, we will, yeah, this is my, by the way, this is my son, Wolfric, no? And this is my husband, Kenneth, and this is me, no? So my husband runs this small business, printing business, and also he takes care of my son as well when I work. So yon. And then, yeah, so for this evening, we will be sharing some inputs that would make us money-wise mothers. Now, so there are different aspects in our life with regards to motherhood. So we need to develop all aspects of our personality. We need to develop our personality with regards to emotional aspect, no? With regards to moral. But this time, we will talk about the most, one of the most, I'm not saying most, but one of the most important aspects. We really need to learn how to be wise with money, especially that we are mothers, diba? So, tayo yung nagbabudget sa family natin. So, we really need to not fail with regards to managing our finances or money for our family. So this is my son, Wolfric, no? And then let's go ahead. All right, so personal finance and motherhood don't have to be complicated, no? So it's just simple. So we will need some guidance with regards to that. So okay, so for tonight, simple lang, konti lang yung topic ko. I'm just gonna be sharing 3 steps to achieve financial security. So can you chat if you are ready? Ready, I'm ready, so that we would start, no? Ready, very good. All right, so for now, we will be sharing the 3 steps to financial security. So number one, we need to know our dreams and our goals, not only for ourselves, but for our family as well. And then we need to know the basics of growing money. And then lastly, we need to know our financial strategy. Kasi hindi naman pwedeng goals ng lahat. Wala tayong plans, wala tayong knowledge, wala tayong strategy in achieving them. So, all right, so mommies, be ready. So we will be breaking it down. All right, number one, step one. So we need to know our dreams and our goals, not only for ourselves, but eventually for our family, no? All right, so who among you have goals? Can you say yes, me on the chat box, no? All right, thank you, Miss Verline, Carla, Len, Demesa, Maria, Josie, Axel. So thank you so much for participating. I really appreciate it. Kasi para akong may kausap kapag you reply on the chat box. So we have goals. So I know we have goals. And then now, type basic goals that you have for your, in general, with your life. Like you want to, it's up to you. Before I show some of the examples here, what are your goals for your family, for yourself, and in life in general? So can you share it to our friends here na nakikinig? Alright, so for example, ako, goal ko na mapaaral yung anak ko sa magandang school. So that's one of the example. Time freedom from Miss Froline. That's really good, di ba? So mas mabuti na kung may a school activity yung anak natin, hindi na tayo magli-leave sa trabaho. So that's time freedom. So that's a goal, no? Achieve financial freedom. So yeah, very, very, financial freedom. So that's really our goal kung bakit tayo nagtatrabaho araw-araw. Increase cash flow, become full-time in IMG, time freedom, no boss, no? For my sons to become entrepreneur and doctor-ish. Wow! Diba? So we have a lot of goals. Now, good thing you are in this class because sometimes pag may goals tayo tapos wala tayong environment wherein we can achieve this, mahihirapan tayo. And good thing you are in this class tonight. So, set your mind on a definite goal and observe how quickly the world stands aside to let you pass. So law of attraction po yan, no? So if you heard about law of attraction, you really need to write down your goals because the universe will conspire to achieve that. So that's according to Napoleon Hill, think and grow rich. All right, and then we have some of the examples here. Define all your goals. Well, travels with family, no? Some of us mothers, hindi pa tayo nakakasal or hindi pa natin nakikita si forever. Ever, like mga single mom, so we have a goal na maikasal tayo, and then we have a car plus house and lot for our family, and then we have gadgets, growth, personal growth, and of course we can help out with regards to charity. And one of the main goals talaga sa ating mga parents na very common is to give or provide for our kids college education. So that's one examples of our goals going forward. Now, how to set goals? So eto, no? So some of the teachings on how to set your goals. So number one, you need to write it down. Right now, okay, so there's a power of writing down your goals. No, like because one, I learned it from my mentor, it's okay to put your goals on an Excel file, you type it on your notepad, but there's science with writing down your goals, because when you write down, all of the neurons of your body will pour it out, like your heart will pour out your heart to that certain goal, and eventually subconsciously you can achieve it. So again, after this talk, you can get a notebook and write your goals down, right? And then be specific as you can. Like for example, I want a house. So magkano? Is it 2-story or 1-story? So how much is your budget? So ganun dapat yung goals. And then set a timeline or deadline. So 10 years from now, I could have my own house. 20 years from now, I will retire. So something like that. And then identify the purpose beyond your goal. So ano bang purpose kung bakit kung sinet itong goal na ito? And then specific action steps. So write down your plans kung ano ang dapat gawin para ma-achieve yung goal na yan. All right. So know what you want, when you want it, and how to achieve it. Yun dapat when regards to writing down our goals. All right now. According to Coach Chai Santiago Gamo, a financial coach, sinabi niya dito, libre lang mangarap, pero hindi libre ang pangarap. Is that right? No, kahit ngayon, pwede itong mangarap, di ba? Mangangarap ako na sana dumating na si Forever, yung mga single moms dyan, no? Nangangarap tayo na sana one day we can fire our boss and spend our time with our family. So, libre lang mangarap, pero hindi libre yung pangarap. Pangarap natin magkabahay at lupa, di ba? Pero hindi libre yun. It takes a lot of sacrifice and money involved in order to achieve that certain goal. All right, so let's accept that fact. All right, so dapat huwag kang drawing, ano, no? So hindi pwedeng hanggang drawing lang tayo sa goals natin. So maraming ganun, 'di ba? Like lahat naman tayo may pangarap, 'di ba? But sometimes majority of people pinaglipasan na lang ng panahon na they reach old age without achieving their goal. So huwag tayong pumayag na ganun. So we still have a lot of chance and time to achieve our goals. So dapat huwag kang drawing, 'di ba? All right, so how do we achieve our goals now? We need a strategy to achieve our goals. All right, and then nandito sa book namin sa IMG yung sinabi ng coach namin, what will you do if you know exactly how to win? All right, of course we would do whatever it takes to win, di ba? Especially if we know how. That's what we call strategy. All right, learning so far? Yes, can you say yes before I proceed to step 2? Learning so far? Walang nagre-reply? Walang na-learn? Alright, thank you so much for replying. Okay, now, again, summary of topic 1, go ahead and write down your goals, no? Para ma-achieve natin ang paunti-unti, no? And then, alright, so step 2, know the basics of growing money. Kasi some of our goals, libre lang mangarap, pero it needs money in order to achieve our goals. So sabi nila, money is not everything. Yeah, that's true naman. But let's admit it to ourselves that lack of money will affect almost everything in our life, right? Like, sabi nila na hindi ka naman sasaya kapag pera lang. Yeah, that's true, but eventually hindi ka naman sasaya kapag mahirap ka, oh, diba? So that's why we have no choice but to grow money, because that's the only way for us to achieve our goals. All right, now eto, no? To gather is to save, to grow is to invest. So in other words, nag-save ka, inilagay mo sa alkansya mo, that's saving, no? That's saving, gathering. And then if you want to make it grow, that's investing. And here, you can read here, provision comes with a purpose. So, bakit ka ba nagsisave? Para saan to? For example, I save money for my kids' college education. So, that's one, what we call purpose. That's example of a purpose. So, ganun dapat. So, dapat alam natin kung ano yung amount, ano kailan natin i-achieve again, no? All right, and then eto, so mga mothers, question is, how do we budget? Sometimes iniisip natin na magandang mag-save, ano po, pero kulang pa yung pera or kulang pa yung budget natin sa kulang pa yung sweldo sa bills natin. So may ituturo tayo dito ng mga formula, but before that, ipapakita muna natin tong tinatawag natin na the poor man's formula. So that's why nahihirapan yung mga mothers or mga millennials or anyone na mag-budget kasi ganito yung formula na ginagamit nila. No? Income minus expenses equals debt. Bakit? Kasi 100% income, they spend twice as their income, 200%. Eventually, ma-negative ka talaga, magkakautang. So, ganun yung mga formula natin. So, dapat, what we need to do is to change our formula to what we call the abundance formula. Now, income, we should give tithes and savings, and then expenses. So, in other words, we need to live below our means. Alright? So, 100% income minus 10% goes to tithes, 20% goes to savings and investment, and live a simple lifestyle. So, ganun dapat. But sometimes, nahihirapan tayong gawin yan kasi kulang yung cash flow. That's why we also need to increase our cash flow as well. Okay? So, do not save what is left after spending. Spend what is left after saving. So, that's according to Warren Buffett, a very successful investor. No? So, okay, if you can track it, you can measure it. If you can measure it, you can manage it. And if you can manage it, you can improve it. Yes? Yes? Can you say yes on the group chat? Yes! Dapat mga mothers tayo, we need to be active, participative. Dapat full of energy. Alright, thank you! So, natutuwa ako kapag nagre-reply kayo kasi it proves na hindi kayo natutulog. Diba? So, thank you. Very good. Thank you so much for replying. I really appreciate it. Alright, let's go ahead and proceed. Alright, now I'm gonna be sharing some concepts here. No? So, sometimes tayo yung mga ilaw ng tahanan. No? So, hindi natin, sabi sa'yo pa, di na ito isalig sa uban na itong balay. Diba? So, dapat in order, dapat ligon, dapat limpyo, diba? So, dapat malinis, no? Dapat maaliwalas, no? Dapat perfect yung tahanan natin. So, same with our finances. So, let's compare it to our finances. Common, solid financial foundation of every Filipino. So, if we build our financial house, sometimes people do it this way, no? So, we invest a little bit, no? May mga lupa tayo, may mga bahay tayo. May savings na kaunti, emergency fund, no? That's good. And then, maraming utang, ouch, di ba? Ang daming may magandang tingnan, may bahay at lupa, may sasakyan, pero puro utang, oh, di ba? That's harsh, but it's true. And then, walang life protection, kakaunti lang. And worst case scenario, walang health care, PhilHealth lang, di ba? So, pag ganito yung itsura ng bahay mo, ano sa tingin mo yung mangyayari? Ano sa tingin mo mangyayari sa bahay mo kapag ganyan yung itsura? If ever may lindol or may typhoon na dumating, so ano mangyayari? Can you chat? Mahugno, matumpag, sa Bisaya pa, sa Tagalog pa, sa may Tagalog, mahugno, magiba, very good, no? So matibag, oh, 'di ba? So nahirapan tas kalisodan eh. Mag-collapse, correct, no? So meaning the solid financial foundation is not strong. So we are mothers here, so dapat we really need to make sure that our financial foundation is strong now. But we fail to plan for the biggest possible financial setbacks of our life. Ano ba yung mga biggest possible financial setbacks? To, no? What if you get sick? Diba? So sometimes overwork tayong mga mothers, hindi na tayo natutulog. Eventually that would backfire on our health, tapos magkasakit tayo, diba? Ano na mangyayari sa pamilya mo? What if you die too soon? Simba ko, no? So this is something that we are too afraid, no? Na sana palagi nating ipinapa-pray kay Lord na sana hindi mangyari. Eto pa, what if you live too long, di ba? So, sometimes living too long is 50-50, good news and bad news. Good news if we live too long, tapos marami tayong pera, di ba? Bad news if wala tayong pera, kasi magiging burden tayo sa family natin, no? In case, instead na yung anak natin, matutupad na sana nila yung pangarap nila, pero yung pera nila, ibinigay pa sa atin, kasi we live too long, tapos nagkasakit tayo. Now, we need to prepare for that. Do you think, if you get sick, die too soon or live long, do you think you're ready? Can you share? No, don't be honest. Can you share? Do you think you're ready if that happens? Me personally, I'm not ready at all. So not yet. All right. That's right. Thank you for being honest, no? Ma'am Fruline, Ma'am Len de Mesa, thank you for responding. So most of us, we are not ready now. How to be prepared when that happens? Now let's break it down. All right. Okay, what if you get sick? now. What do you think that is something that could help us and make us prepared when we get sick? Any idea? No? Huwag na sumagot yung mga members, yung mga guests yung sumagot. No? Kasi yung mga members alam na nila kung ano yon. Yung mga guests, no? Ano sa tingin mo yung makakasalba sa'yo kapag nagkasakit ka na hindi matitibag yung solid financial foundation? Walang sumagot? Members ba lahat ng tao dito na nakikinig? Alright, so ako na lang sasagot sa tanong ko, no? So what if you get sick? You will be needing healthcare, no? So healthcare, yan po yung makakapagbayad sa hospital bills natin. So iba po yung get from savings or from relatives. Okay, so that's possible, but the best thing is healthcare talaga, no? Mas maganda kayang hindi manghingi, ano po, no? So okay, then may mga relatives din naman tayo na mga helpful. All right, so healthcare is the best solution. So secondary na po yung manghingi sa relative. So primary solution is healthcare. Now, so there are two types of healthcare. Now, may tinatawag tayo na short-term healthcare. So normally it is your benefit as an employee, no? Employment or productive years. Habang nagtatrabaho ka, libre ka ng healthcare benefits sa company mo. Alright, so one examples of short-term healthcare, ito po, di ba? So before I worked as a graphic designer, so I had generally Philippines as my healthcare. That was okay, but when I resigned from my job, wala na akong healthcare kasi hindi naman sa akin yun, sa company naman yun. So, yung iba na we are so dependent on that, like, I don't need healthcare kasi libre naman yun sa company ko. But what if mag-resign ka sa company mo? Hindi, mawawala na yung healthcare mo. That's why it's not really, short-term healthcare is good, but what we advise people really is this, tinatawag natin na, by the way, short-term healthcare, when you retire, wala ka ng healthcare kasi up to 60 or 65 ka lang naman magtatrabaho. Alright, after you retire or resign from your company, goodbye free HMO, goodbye free healthcare, no, wala ka ng healthcare. So what we really recommend, itong tinatawag natin na long-term healthcare. So ano ba tong long-term healthcare na to? So employment, productive years, you have to get it for yourself while you're young. So while you're still working, start getting a long-term healthcare now. No, yan yung pareha ng mga countries like US or Canada wherein yung mga matatanda nila, they can afford to pay caregivers, they can pay for expensive hospitals because when they were still young, they are saving for tinatawag natin na long term, no? So hindi mo yan kukunin kapag matanda ka na. Dapat kunin mo yan kapag healthy ka pa. All right, now is it available in the Philippines? Yes, it is available, no? So that's something that would help you when you retire, no? So covered ka po ng healthcare until age, whatever age, as long as there's still funds on your account. So we have, si IMG ang organization namin, wala naman kaming product, but we have partner company, tinatawag namin to na Kaiser, but I won't discuss too much about this, but just a little bit of an overview. You will just save for 7 years and then you are covered for healthcare even you are already 100 years old. So what you need to do after this class is to talk to the person who invited you and you ask for a quote. Kasi iba-iba po yung range niya ng price range ng benefits kasi it depends on the age. It also depends on what you require or what the capability to pay, you know, you can choose whatever you want from this. So again, that's Kaiser. What you need to do after this class, ask the person who invited you for a quote so that ma-plan out mo yung needs mo going forwards. Okay. So dili na tapagahi-gahi, no? Kay usahay mo yung taad, I don't need healthcare. Well, let's see, no? You don't need healthcare if you are sure that you're never going to get sick, which is really I'm not sure, which is really impossible. Kasi one time in our life, magkakasakit talaga tayo, no? Musurinder ato ang lawas, no? One day, especially if we are a very hardworking mother. And then, you don't need healthcare if you think you can bring your healthcare company's healthcare even after you retire, which is really impossible, di ba? If you think your government can take care of your healthcare needs like maintenance, medicines, check-up, so yung ayuda ng senior citizen, at magkano lang naman yun, 500 pesos, so it's not enough, di ba? And then, you don't need long-term healthcare if you expect your children to take care of you. So that's still possible, but nakakaawa naman yung mga anak natin, di ba? Nagawin natin silang investment. Kasi yung mindset, kadalasang mindset ng mga Pinoy, bahala na malubog ako sa utang, mapatapos ko lang yung anak ko kasi yung anak ko mag-aahon sa akin sa kahirapan. I'm sorry to tell you, no offense, but that's really a wrong mindset na kailangan nating i-change. Kaya tayo nanatiling mahirap na country kasi we are having this wrong culture. Kasi yung mga anak natin, hindi din naging mayaman kasi they are obliged to take care of their parents when they get old. So what which is better is yung parent ka, you are prepared for your retirement, may long-term healthcare ka, may pera ka, para yung mga anak mo maka-focus also in building their own lives, in achieving their own dreams. Alright? And then, okay. So, the comfort level of your healthcare situation after age 60 depends on the decision that you make today. So, you are a better millennial, better mother, no? So, if you are still a millennial and a mother, so you still have a lot of time to save for it. And if you are already on your midlife, no, around 40s, you still have time as well. So, if you are on your 50s, still have time. So, as long as hindi pa huli ang lahat, so dapat better late than never. All right? Okay? The most important asset that you need to invest on is yourself, no? So invest on yourself first. So before ka bumili ng mga branded clothes, ng mga luho mo, ng mga bags mo, make sure you invest on your healthcare kasi magba-backfire po yan sa financial house mo when the one of those kinds of situation happens, no? Yung mga pagsubok na health situation. Kasi did you know that healthcare is the number one cause of financial bankruptcy? No, maraming mga tao na nakapagpundar ng mga lupa, mga properties, but then nagkasakit, sayang lahat ng naipundar nila kasi walang healthcare. Now you know better, no? So I will share my personal story because my father, hindi siya na-hospitalize sa buong buhay niya, he's already 68 years old now. Na last year, inatake sa puso. First time niyang na-hospital, first time niyang na-dextrose, di ba? But then, kung atakihin ka sa puso, dapat ICU. Kasi yun yung napaka-critical ng condition. So, walang healthcare yung father ko. So, yung ginawa naming mga anak, nag-meeting kami, nag-chip in kami para sa hospital bill. Ang mahal-mahal pa naman ng ICU. So, even though we would do anything to save our loved ones, but it's also good that when we get old, hindi na mamu-problema yung mga anak natin kapag nagkasakit tayo. Do you think that makes sense? Can you say yes? Can you say if you agree or disagree with me? No? So, do you think it makes sense yung lahat ng sinasabi ko? Yes? Walang nagre-replies? Okay, agree. Right. Thank you so much. Right. Very good. I'm happy that you are agreeing kasi may iba na hindi nag-a-agree dito. Kasi may nakausap ako before ang sabi niya, hindi ako papabayaan ng anak ko. O, diba? So, ganun. So, I'm happy that you have a different mindset. You have a mindset to win in life and that's really good. Now, since you agree sa lahat ng sinabi ko, now, we will proceed to the next pagsubok, possible na mangyari sa buhay natin. Ito po, na what if you die too soon? Ito yung talagang kinatatakutan natin, no? So, maliliit pa yung mga anak natin, buyag simba ko, no? So, hindi naman tayo si Cardo Dalisay na hindi natin alam kung ano mangyayari sa atin, di ba? So, si Cardo Dalisay hindi na mamatay kahit binaril na, no? Ngayon lang siya namatay na wala na yung ABS-CBN. Corny, di ba? Ang corny ko naman, di ba? So, what if you die too soon? May memorial plan na kami. Alright, that's good. No, I'm not saying memorial plan is not good. That's okay as well. Kasi may memorial plan din naman ako. So, what if you die too soon? Memorial plan is just secondary. No, sorry. Secondary lang po si memorial plan. Primary thing that you need is life insurance. Kasi yung memorial plan, buyag taon palayo, no? So, simba ko. Yung memorial plan is okay, just enough for our burial or needs. Yung may kabaong tayo, yung memorial lot natin, wala nang mga anong tawag ito? Gisilhiga ng mga amigas, di ba? So, may mga lights na yung wake natin. That's okay, but what will happen to your family after ka nailibing? Ano yung kakainin nila? Sino mapapaaral sa anak mo? Eto, life insurance. Now, it's okay to have no memorial plan and you have life insurance. Yun dapat, di ba? Yung Pinoy, kasi ayoko ng life insurance, may memorial na naman ako. So, again, as what I've said, life insurance is something that would allow your family to continue the same lifestyle na nakagawian nila. So, right? So, kadalasan mga Pinoy may memorial, walang life insurance. That's really sad. All right, now, question. Eto. Is it beneficial for mothers and stay-at-home parents to have life insurance? What do you think? Kasi sometimes, kadalasan na wrong notion is yung kung sino yung breadwinner ng family, siya lang dapat yung may life insurance. What do you think? If you are a stay-at-home mother, tapos may husband ka nagtatrabaho sa'yo, do you think you need life insurance? Can you answer? What do you think? Yes. Yes. Alright, so yes. Yes, that's the answer. Very good. Thank you for participating. Why? Because eto, no? Okay, if you are a stay-at-home mother, you are insurable, more or less. Kasi, yung mga nagtatrabaho sa mga hazardous work, like mga police, mga firefighters, yung mga ganon. So, hindi sila masyadong insurable kasi hazard, may hazard sa trabaho nila. So, eto, pag stay-at-home parent tayo, no, we are insurable kasi we are, hindi naman tayo exposed sa mga hazards na ganyan. And, we need life insurance because we have valuable services na nai-offer sa family. Like, we are the cook, the driver, the cleaner, the teacher, the accountant, etc. So, ang dami nating pinagagawa kaya, superwoman tayo. So, and according to salary.com, the monetary value of our services as a mother is as high as if we had a full-time job. No, mag-hire ka kaya ng cook. Ang mahal-mahal kaya niyan, di ba? Mag-hire ka ng driver, mag-hire ka ng cleaner. So, mas mabuti pang mag-stay at home ka na lang, di ba? Kasi mag-pay ka ng services na ganyan. So, yes, the answer is yes. We need life insurance even if we are just staying at home. Alright? Okay, that's good. At least we agree on that. Lahat kami, my life insurance from Sherry Lim. Very good. No, you are really a model to everyone. All right. Okay, now, remember that the purpose of your life insurance is to protect your family. So, not to protect you, but to protect your family in case God calls us home early. All right? So, buyag si bako. But even if it's, we say buyag si bako palayo, no? So, even if we knock on wood, no, we don't really want that to happen, but eventually only God knows, no, mas mabuti nang prepare, di ba? Si Kobe Bryant nga, sumakay lang ng airplane, hindi na nakauwi sa kanila. Mabuti na lang, marami siyang perang naiwan sa pamilya, no? Tayo, ano may iwan natin sa pamilya natin, utang, di ba? So, dapat hindi ganyan. So, life insurance is an instant money that we rent temporary money since we don't have kayamanan na maiiwan sa family yet, yung kaya lang nating bilhin as of now is life insurance to protect our family. Alright? That's good. Okay, next. Eto, what if you live too long? Diba? Eto yung tanong, no? So, ang answer dito is investment. So, dapat we should be living on interest. Yun yung tinatawag natin na LOI, living on interest. Kasi kapag hindi ka nakapag-prepare for retirement, you will be living only on yourself. LOOY, living only on yourself. Yun, di ba? Corny. Okay, so how does money work? Can we make money work for us? So, that's investment. So, basic lang na isi-share natin for tonight. Alright, compounding interest. So, when we invest, it should have rate of return and that involves compounding interest. That's how money works. No? So, every time money moves in the financial industry, if it has interest rate, may tinatawag tayo na compounding. So, ano bang ibig sabihin ng compounding? Pag doble ng pera, pag rolyo, nanganganak yung pera, ganon. Compounding interest can work in favor of us if we save and invest, tapos may tubo yung savings natin. And it can also work against us if we utang. Kasi may tubo din yung utang, no? So, money works against us kapag may interest yung utang natin. Alright, so according to my lolo, Albert Einstein, so to know when your money will compound or double, use this formula na tinatawag natin na rule of 72. Sabi ni Einstein, 72 daw, divided by interest rate ng savings natin or utang, no, applicable for both, malalaman natin number of years it will take for our money to double. Simple lang, kahit hindi tayo accounting graduate, kahit hindi tayo magaling sa math, we can easily remember this. Again, 72 divided by interest, annual interest rate equals number of years it will take for your money to double. Yun lang, no, di ba? Paano ba na come up ni Einstein yung number 72? I don't know. Itanong natin si Einstein kung paano niya na come up ang constant number na 72. Alright, so again, 72 divided by interest rate, annual interest rate equals number of years it will take for a given fund to double. Question, example, no? So, 72, for example, may 1% interest, annual interest yung savings natin. Example, 72 divided by 1 equals 72 years. So, therefore, if 1% lang yung tubo ng pera natin, it will take 72 years for our money to double. Question, Get the chat box ready. Saan mo inalalagay yung savings mo ngayon? Common Pinoy, saan natin ipinapatubo yung pera natin? Any idea? Any idea? Bank. Correct. Land de mesa, bank. That's right. May iba pang sagot? Bank. Buy real estate. All right? Okay, bank. So, majority sa sagot is bank. Now, next question. How much is the interest rate of the bank? Right? Can you reply? Well, I'll drink some water. Interest rate of the bank. 0.25. Correct, no? So, it differs. Depende sa bank. Yung iba, 0.10. Yung iba, 0.20. It depends. So, example, let's say, we put our money in the bank. Example lang, no? Let's say, naglagay tayo ng pera sa banko, tapos yung interest niya, annual interest is 0.2. 72 divided by 0.2 equals 360 years. So, if yung pera mo na sa banko, it will take 360 years for your money to double, di ba? Buhay ka pa kaya nun. No? So it's not advisable to put your long-term investment into the bank, unfortunately. So, the banks, I'm not saying the banks are bad, but banks are just for emergency funds. If you have business na kailangan natin na iparolyo yung pera natin, kailangan natin ng convenience, banks are okay. But with regards to long-term investments, ano ba mga example ng long-term goals? College plan ng anak natin, we have retirement, so it shouldn't be put on the bank kasi matagal siya before mag-double. So example, saan ba natin ilalagay dapat yung mga long-term investments? So, here, I have an example here, 12%. So, 72 divided by 12 equals 6 years. Therefore, if you put your money in 12% annual interest rate, your money will double every 6 years. Do you think it's ideal, 12%? Yes? Question, i-guess nyo kung saan to. Saan ba yung mga legal na mga investment vehicles na nagbibigay ng 12% na interest rate? MF, very good. No, so what is MF? Mutual fund. So stock market, yun. So yung mga mutual fund investments na yan, so yan yung pinaka-highest and most sustainable so far. Kapag may nagbigay sa'yo na higher than 12%, or especially monthly interest rate, you go to the opposite direction. Kasi scam po yan. Especially if monthly yung interest rate. Ngayon, may bago na namang scam, di ba? So, hindi talaga people never really learn, no? Yung mga kapa, yun yung mga scam. 30% per month, yun yung tubo. Kaya yung Pinoy na hindi financially educated, gustong yumaman kagad, ayun, nag-invest, nawala tuloy lahat ng pinaghirapan nila. So, be careful when you invest. Make sure it's legal and make sure it's sustainable. Alright? Okay, so we are better mothers here. That's why we attend this class. Yung ibang mother na in-invite, hindi nag-attend kasi manunood daw sila ng TV, mag-Facebook. But you're here with us now. So meaning you are a different breed of a mother. So that's why I appreciate you all. Now, I'm gonna teach you, since you spend time with us, I'm gonna teach you kung saan yan ilalagay. No, example. My mother dito, Esther yung pangalan niya. Example lang. Tapos yung edad niya ngayon, 27 years old. So, nag-save siya ng 100,000. Investment vehicle. So, example lang, no? Annual interest, number of years for her to double the money and earning before age 60. Itong si Esther, saver. No? Example lang. What if inilagay niya sa wallet or sa kaban or sa ilalim ng unan yung pera niya? Magkano interest rate niyan? Wala, di ba? Wala, hindi naman tutubo yun. Alkansya, di ba? Alkansiya. Alkansisiya, di ba? And then, in other words, hindi siya magdodoble kasi wala namang interest rate noon. So, earning before age 60, walang earning yung pera niya kasi hindi nagdouble. So, in other words, if you put your money in your wallet or in your kaban or in your unan, it's not gonna work. And the liki sa kawayan, no? It's not gonna work, no? So, don't do that kasi aanayin lang yung pera mo sa kaban, di ba? What if you put your money in a savings account? All right. Now, how much is the interest rate of the savings account? 0.20. So, it will take 360 years for your money to double. So, it's not ideal, no? So, insignificant. So, don't ever think about that at all. Now, what if you put your money in time deposit? Example, 1% time deposit. Yung time deposit, iba yung savings account na may ATM card wherein we can withdraw our money anytime. Time deposit, yun yung mga inalalock up yung pera natin, like 5 years na hindi ma-withdraw, ganun. So, it doubles every 72 years. So, therefore, at age 60, si Esther, meron siyang less than 200,000. Is that enough kapag nag-retire siya? Hindi, di ba? So, the best option is to put Esther's money in the stocks or mutual fund that have annual interest rate of 12%. So 72 divided by 12, it doubles every 6 years. Now, 27 years old, 100,000 yung pera ni Esther. After 6 years, 33 years old, naging 200,000. Another 6 years, naging 400. So as you notice, the next time na nag-double yung pera, ito ng amount na to ang basis, hindi na si principal amount. And then another 6 years, Esther, at age 57, Esther can retire with 3.2 million pesos. Do you think it makes sense? Mutual fund? Do you think it makes sense? Yes? Right. Very good. No, walang nag-reply. Alright, super. Very good. No, so when the first time I heard or I listened to this organization that I'm in right now, wherein I chose to do full time, I was really so surprised by this concept na tinatawag natin na rule of 72. Kasi yung family namin, wala kaming background sa business. I'm not really, hindi talaga ako aware na nag-i-exist pala to. So sometimes when people deposit money in the bank reinvest their money here. No, so ito lang yung kita ni Esther, hindi niya alam na 3.2 million pala yung tubo ng pera niya. Okay, and that's the cost of financial education. So that's why we are really passionate in educating people. So we have events for millennials, and now we have events for mothers, kasi we help a lot of people because growing money the right way is something that could help you achieve your dreams. Especially that may mga anak tayo, no? So kailangan talaga nating hindi maka-make ng anong mang mistake with regards to our money decisions. And you are blessed that you're here with us tonight. Okay, now. Alright, so the solid financial foundation. So we were talking about investments, right? So, and that's exciting. No, exciting naman talaga mag-invest. Parang astig, di ba? Investor ako, di ba? Astig. Pag may nakarinig na investor ka, parang mabibelieve talaga sa'yo. But as you notice here, investment is the last step with regards to achieving our goal. So before you invest, pay attention to this. You need emergency fund. Right? Now, because if you don't have emergency fund and you invest in the stock market, nag-invest ka ng real estate, bumili ka ng bahay at lupa, kapag may emergency, nawalan ka ng trabaho, mawawala lahat ng in-invest mo. Sayang ang effort mo. So before you invest, you need emergency fund. And before you save emergency fund and invest, make sure your debt is manageable or na-eliminate na lahat yung utang mo. Kasi laki kayo ng interest ng utang, di ba? Monthly yun. Yung 5, 6, 10% per month, no? Yung credit card, 3.5% per month. Tapos yung growth ng savings natin sa time deposit, 1% per year. Di ba? Lugi ka po kapag may utang ka. So make sure we eliminate yung utang. And then, if ikaw yung breadwinner ng family, you need to protect yourself with life insurance. Kasi, anhin mo naman yung napakarami mong bahay na investment and stock market na investment. Tapos ikaw yung breadwinner ng family, tapos kinuha ka ni Lord, mauubos din lahat ng naipundar mo. So, it's not wise to invest without protection or life insurance. Especially, eto, healthcare. That's the very bottom of our financial foundation. So, kapag nagkasakit tayo, hindi mauubos lahat ng investment natin. So, ito po yung solid financial foundation na tinuturo natin sa mga tao. So, you really need to start with healthcare first before you invest. Yung ibang mga kakilala ko na bumibili ng mga mamahaling bag, ganun, investment daw nila sa sarili, di ba? Paano pag nagkasakit ka, anhin mo yung bag mo, anhin mo yung branded na clothes mo, anhin mo yung magandang bahay mo, maibibenta mo lang naman yan kapag wala kang healthcare. Now that you know better, when you save and invest for your future, when you build your solid financial foundation, start from the ground up, no? Evaluate yourself, evaluate your family, kung ano yung kulang mo dyan sa mga building blocks na yan. Kung kulang, hindi pa naman huli ang lahat. You still have the chance to do it right. Alright? So, learning so far? Yes? Yes! I need to make sure you're still not sleeping, no? Before I proceed. Okay, thank you, Ma'am Froline, Maria Flor, Len De Mesa, for responding, no? Gusto ko talaga kapag may nagre-respond. Kasi, sure ako na nakikinig kayo sa akin. Hindi ko kaya kayo nakikita, no? Baka nagsasalita lang ako, walang nakikinig. Thank you very much for your overwhelming responses. Salamat. Alright, now, the kind of life that you live tomorrow depends on the choices that you make today. Tapos, we are mothers here. So, we make important decisions for our family. Alright, now, do something today that your future self will thank you for. So, siguro mag-retire tayo, no? Tapos, we have a comfortable life. We will thank ourselves, no? Our future self will thank us. Mabuti na lang may investment ako sa stock market, nakapag-retire ako ng maayos, no? Mabuti na lang may healthcare ako, long-term healthcare. Nagkasakit ako ngayon, hindi na nang problema yung anak ko. Bumisita na lang yung anak ko, tapos nag-care sa akin, hindi na siya gumastos kasi I can afford to pay for my own hospital bills. O, diba? So, dapat ganun. Diba? So, again, this sometimes, kung sabi saya pa, mulusot na sa itong pikas dunggan ba? But I know deep inside your hearts that what I'm saying here makes sense. And you have the power to control your life. It's up to you to apply what you've learned or not. Because sometimes we know that it's right, but then we don't apply. Yung tinatawag natin na analysis paralysis. So we just learn, para tayong seminarista, no? Seminar ng seminar, hindi natin in-apply lahat ng na-learn natin. Alright, now, let's go to step 3. Let's go to applying what we've learned. So now that we know our goals already, we identified our goals as step 1. Then step 2, we learned some knowledge about growing money. Let's go to step 3, know your financial strategy. Part 1 pa po ito kasi may part 2 po ito, pero ito lang muna for now. Kasi baka ma-info overload kayo and it's already 9:56, so malapit na tayong matapos. Step 3 na. Okay, so there is precious treasure and oil in the house of the wise who prepare for the future. But a short-sighted and foolish man swallows it up and wastes it. So that's according to Proverbs 20:21. So, if you are a wise person, so there is a precious treasure and oil in your house. But if you are a foolish person, so na-waste lang lahat ng pera. Ang dami kayang ganun, malaki yung sweldo, pero walang naipon kahit konti. Pero meron ding mga taong minimum lang yung sweldo, pero may ipon. So it's not the income, no? It's how you manage your finances. And that involves a lot of financial education. So ito yung ginagawa namin dito sa IMG. So baka nagtataka kayo, bakit ba ang daming classes ni IMG about financial literacy? Kasi yun po yung advocacy namin, na i-educate yung mga tao financially. So, we don't give people fish directly, but we teach people how to fish. Okay? So, eto na yung mga strategy. Number 1, so develop the right mindset. So, here are the few tips to get you started. You can take note. Now, number 1, increase your financial IQ. That's the first one. Because kahit manalo pa tayo sa loto ng 50 million, if hindi natin alam yung kung paano gagawin sa pera natin, mauubos lang yan, mawawalang parang bula. No? Ganun kaya, madaming Pinoy na nanalo sa loto na bumalik pa din sa pagiging mahirap. Kasi, their mindset is not ready for blessings. So what we need to do now, kahit hindi pa tayo nananalo sa loto, is we prepare our mindset and financial IQ para when the blessing comes, hindi siya mawawala, mapipreserve natin kasi we are ready for abundant blessings. Okay, number 2, before that, financial IQ is a measure of how well you do with money. Having a high financial IQ doesn't mean that your investments outperform the market or predict you'll retire a millionaire. So, kapag may alam ka sa pera, kung paano mag-cost averaging, so we won't discuss technical stock market investing because we are still beginners here. Dudugo yung ilong natin kapag i-discuss natin yan. So, you are invited on our next classes to learn more about all of those things. And then, rather, it means you handle money responsibly. You make smart money decisions and spend and save according to plan. So, that's financial IQ. No, hindi ka magpa-panic buying, di ba? Kung alam mong yung pera na to para to sa retirement ko, yung pera na to para to sa college ng anak ko. So, kapag may nakita kang sale sa mall, hindi ka na maa-attract na bumili niyan or mag-overspend. Kasi you have goals for your money. So, that's financial IQ. That's proven and tested. Napakagastador ko kaya noon before. But now na IMG na ako, I learned to control the spending na. And I invite you all to be part of our organization as well, to be influenced, to become a better person. Okay? Alright. Okay, next is increase your cash flow. So, after increasing your financial IQ, you need to increase your cash flow. Kasi paano ka naman makakapag-save and invest kapag hindi kulang yung pera mo? Yung pera mo kulang pa sa bill. So, increase your cash flow. Have multiple sources of income. So, that's the second strategy that you need to do. Make as much money as you can, no? While you can, have multiple sources of income. As long as legal, no? Huwag ka nang kumuha ng hindi legal dyan, no? So, may kakilala kaya akong IMG na nag-invest doon sa scam kasi multiple sources of income. No, parang sinira mo lang yung pangalan mo dyan, no? So, the earlier you start, the earlier you get your goals. All right, so spend less and reduce your expenses. So wag ka nang mag-live a very luxurious lifestyle. So just be contented to be just live simply, no? So ako hindi ako mahilig talaga sa mga jewelry, sa mga branded clothes, no? Nagsusuot nga ako ng ukay-ukay. So ganun lang dapat, hindi naman tayo mamamatay, no? So dapat we kasi may goals tayo, no? Goal kong paaralin yung anak ko sa LaSalle. So dapat I need to save for his college education. So hindi na lang ako magbibili ng mga luho ko. So spend less, reduce your expenses. And then remember, it's not how much you earn that counts, it's how you keep. So set aside 20% of your income to save and invest, no? So number 4 strategy is to zero out bad debts. No, bayaran natin yung mga utang natin sa credit card, yung mga bad debts natin. So we need to pay it off kasi it will drain our financial anong tawag ito? Financial wallet talaga kapag may utang tayo. Interest on debts are like leaks that drain your finances. No? And then, number 5, seek a mentor. So, you can't really win in life without a coach. No? That's what I learned. No? And then, for example, si Manny Pacquiao, yung coach niya si Freddie Roach, di ba? So lahat ng tao may coach para maging successful. Same with our game, no? With our game to the with regards to money game, no? So dapat tayong may mentor tayo. But mahal kumuha ng mga mentor. So be a member of IMG kasi automatic you have a lot of mentors automatically. And I'm so thankful to my mentors as well for bringing out the best in me, which is really good. You cannot do it alone, no? Sabi mo, matipid naman akong tao, pero yung mga kasama mo sa trabaho, gastador lahat. Na-influence ka din maging gastador. So you need to join a community of financial advocates. So yun. So dapat you need to be influenced for the better. Kasi when you join a group that saves, you will also save. No, be with a group who inspires you. When the members of your group save, they will also inspire you to save and invest. And that's IMG. Ito yung pinagmamalaki ko talaga dito na marami kaming natutunan, maraming benefits. And if you want to learn more about our IMG membership benefits, you could ask a person who invited you. He or she will discuss what are the benefits of our organization. And then, eto po yung mga some of our group members. So, be one of us. So, eto yung mga travels namin. We went to Korea. Eto po. Tapos, we went to Hong Kong Disneyland. And we, this is Malaysia. And we have conventions wherein we learn unlimitedly. And we have friends, no? So, you have good friends that would influence you to become better. Kasi sabi nga nila, you are the average of the 5 people that you are with, no? So, kapag yung mga kaibigan mo, mga sugarol, mga gastador, magiging katulad ka din nila. So, if you are with IMG, these people save and invest in mutual funds. So, parang nagigilty ka kapag hindi ka nag-save. So, that's really a good benefit na para sa akin, a very main benefit na nakuha ko sa IMG, no? Alright, be one of us sa IMG. And then, next step is to do financial check-up. So again, set for second appointment with the person who invited you. And those who found this post on a Facebook page, you go back to that Facebook page and then approach the message, the admin, and say, admin, gusto ko ng financial check-up. So to check on how financially healthy are you so that you would know where to get started. No, so kung may check-up sa health natin, malaman natin kung anong sakit natin, bibigyan tayo ng reseta kung para sa lunas ng mga sakit natin. Same with ang sakit sa bulsa, no? Dapat natin i-check up kung paano siya malulunasan, di ba? Alright, the next, get smarter about money. You can take a screenshot of this slide and then try budgeting your finances. So how much is your income? You put here, 10% goes to tithes, long-term healthcare. So ito yung dapat mong gawin. So ito yung topic before ka mag-proceed sa financial check-up session. Make sure you fill this up with your current financial status so that the person that would do the financial check-up would know what ano yung i-advise niya na strategy sa'yo going forwards. Okay, and then if you keep doing the same things, you will keep getting the same results. So change is a decision. So before, lahat naman tayong gustong umasenso. No? Financial independence, not a dream, but it's a decision. So sometimes nga gusto natin umasenso, ma-achieve yung mga goals natin, hindi natin alam kung paano, di ba? So paano ba natin ma-achieve yung mga goals? Now, here you are in this class and you know that there's an organization called IMG that would help you achieve your goals. So you just need to decide to be one of us. So to become a member, you just have to pay online, fill up a form, and have some basic requirements. So you can already join our organization. All right. And then, all right. So join. And then own, create a program, savings program is either long-term healthcare or whatever. No, long-term healthcare yung pinaka-best na starting investment kasi yun po yung pinaka-bottom sa financial foundation. And you share this to people because it's something that could change your lives, no? Nag-share nga tayo kapag nakapanood tayo ng magandang movie. Uy, magandang movie yung napanood ko, panoodin mo din. How much more you learn from this class? Tapos share mo na, huy, mag-save ka ng healthcare kasi yan yung number one cause of financial bankruptcy. You change lives of people. And this is really what the reason why I stick with this company because para sa akin this is something that would give you purpose, 'di ba? So nakakatulong ka sa ibang tao talaga. And kapag nagpasalamat sila sa iyo, hindi nababayaran ng kahit anong monetary amount yung mga nangyayari sa buhay natin. All right? Okay, so be part of our campaign, no? So be part of our Facebook group, Life of a Financial Educator. So make sure you join and then give your email to the person who invited you because my campaign kami to educate 10 million financially educated families by 2025. And as of now, we are at 1.6 million. And if you give your email address to the person who invited you, you will be part of the counter even if you still hindi ka pa nag-join sa organization as long as nakapag-listen ka sa class namin. And of course, if you give your email address to your inviter, masasali ka sa raffle namin ng free iPad. Gusto niyo ba ng iPad? Can you say yes if gusto niyo ng iPad? Walang nag-reply. Sa akin na lang yung iPad nyo. If ayaw nyo. I'm just joking. Yay! Gusto na ng iPad. So again, give your email to the person who invited you. So that's all for my talk. And before we close it out, I'm gonna give the floor to my mentor, also a mother, and my mentor, Ma'am Joanne Faller. So go ahead, Ma'am Jo. All right, can't unmute. Wait lang. Sorry, hanapin ko muna. All right, unmute. Sorry. All right, go ahead.
Okay, hello. Good evening. Narinig ba Coach Rose?
Yes, clear.
Okay, so congratulations no everyone. So happy Mother's Day. So hello sa mga momshies. Okay? So congratulations everyone for attending even if this is just a short notice, no? So we were able to deliver with the help of Coach Rose and the team. So I've learned a lot from the sharing and from the session. And I'm also personally thankful because of IMG. Kay kung wala tayo sa IMG ngayon, so where do we get this kind of inputs? So di ba sa couple, there is such thing as marriage encounters. Yeah. Kung sa mga parenting, meron din gayong mga ganun na mga seminars, pero when it comes to money, limited lang yung ang opportunity of this type of session. So that's why we are so blessed because we have IMG. So ang role as a mother, kay dako gyud. Ayo. So we have a big role in our family. So if we don't have IMG, it would be a difficult financial journey. I just remember that when my father died, I was still high school and I have four siblings. And I really saw my mother struggle and adjust on top of the emotional side as well as the financial side. So, and we have only tindahan as a source of income, only one tindahan as a source of income. So I just can imagine how my mother decided every day to be strong during the time even until now. So she is already 70 years old. So moving forward, if we want financial change, if we want to achieve a financial success or to achieve a better life for our family, it's always a decision. So take note, it's always a decision. It's not a one-time deal. But it's a daily decision to make as mothers and wives. So we have a lot of friends pa, no? So a lot of mothers na hindi pa alam si IMG. So we have to help each other and bring them here and help them earn also additional income para ma-achieve yung goals din nila. So very important yung additional income sa panahon ngayon. So like silang Coach Rose, para average income nila sa team is mga nasa 10,000 to 20,000 per week. Imagine, per week. And may iba tayong ka-team like Coach Hera, who is listening right now, so also earn the same. So most of the team members are part-time, so if they can manage to do it, so all of us can do it. Okay, so Coach Rose, thank you for letting me share. So I'll give you back to Coach Rose.
Alright, so thank you, Coach Joanne. So, nalaman tuloy nila yung income. Alright, so, yung income ni Coach Joanne, secret lang, na mas malaki pa dun. Alright, so, again, happy Mother's Day to everyone. Now, I hope you learned a lot. I appreciate all your appreciation on the group chat. And it's really a pleasure to serve you all. So, even if, pang ilang meeting ko na to for today, but I never get tired of sharing IMG to people, no, kahit na maubos pa yung boses ko. So, thank you so much, mothers. Happy Mother's Day. And go ahead and talk to the person who invited you. So, apply what you've learned because this is something that could change your family's life. So, God bless po. God bless everyone. Thank you.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion, like how a single